So in our essential vital elemental series, today we'll be talking about phosphorus. I guess much of you are not aware of it because there has been no much of a supplementation which we talk for the so-called phosphorus deficiency. But on large scale, if you try to look at the functions of phosphorus in the body, phosphorus is a very essential element when it comes to health of your bones and teeth. Phosphorus is also an essential element when it comes to DNA and RNA replication. Phosphorus is also one of the key sources of energy. The ATP, what we call as adenosine triphosphate, is because of the phosphorus in the system. So this is also needed to maintain the pH of your extracellular fluid such that it doesn't become much of acidic in nature and hampering the metabolic activity of all the other enzymes. So when we talk about these wide array of functionality of phosphorus, we need somewhere close to 700 to 1000 mg of phosphorus every day. So a high protein diet and a high calcium diet can actually increase the amount of phosphorus in the system. Mind you, this also comes with a lot of other problems which we'll be talking later. So when we just say high protein, it is not just binging or only protein sources, but nuts, low-fat dairy, grains which contains higher protein than the rest of the normal non-synthetic protein diets can actually help in enhancing the phosphorus in the system. So as I was mentioning, the importance of higher proteins and higher calcium is because phosphorus doesn't have its own enzyme to be absorbed in intestine or in stomach. So phosphorus has to react externally with calcium and sodium to become something called as dicalcium phosphate or disodium phosphate, or has to be having something called as phosphoric acid. So only these will help in enhancing the absorption of phosphorus. So that is the reason why when phosphorus combines with calcium, which we call as hydroxyapatite, is one of the important component for your health of your bone and the enamel of your tooth. So let's assume that, as I was telling, too much of binge eating on protein can reduce the calcium intake, and that can increase the serum PTH level. This increased serum PTH level will reduce the bone mineral density that can lead to osteoporotic changes in your bones. So at the same time, let's assume that you are having high phosphorus in your diet through high protein intake. So that can eventually gets into your kidneys. When in kidneys, it's not absorbed well, and let's say you have a dehydration problem, then this can lead to larger accumulation of phosphorus in kidneys, leading to kidney failure. So that is the reason why you need to drink adequate water if you are on a high protein rich diet. Along with that, you need to also understand that hormones such as estrogen and adrenaline can also affect the phosphorus balance in the system. So drinking well, keeping yourself stress free is one of the key importance to make sure that the phosphorus is abundantly found in your system. And drinking water is not just about talking about the importance of water ingestion, but to enhance the phosphorus in the system as well. So as I said, ATP is one of the important source for you to keep your body at very high energy, or keeping your body at very good metabolic activity. So water will enhance this free phosphorus in the system, that will also keep you more active. So especially people who are fasting, my one request would be to keep drinking adequate water, just to make sure that you are active no matter what happens. So a dry fasting where you don't even drink water can obviously lead to lower amount of phosphorus in the system, and that can lead to hampered energy output, and that can lead to more complications. So that is the reason why when you're fasting, if you have not heard about fasting, check out the link below. I have obviously given you the link about fasting and its importance on body. So when we talk about the same thing, as I said, there are a lot of cases on deficiency rather than toxicity. So a deficient phosphorus can lead to variety of differences in the body. So something called as anemia, which we have talked in a recent video, to something which is very much out of the context of the body, like confusion. So muscle weakness, bone strength density, and all those things will reduce if you are not having adequate phosphorus in your diet. So one such is called as hypophosphatemia, which is basically lower phosphate in the blood, can be caused because of hyperparathyroidism and diabetic ketoacidosis. On the other hand, when we say about kidney disease, you need to understand about the phosphate. So chronic kidney disease can be a very common factor when we see patients with high phosphate, and also atherosclerosis can lead to higher toxicity in the body for phosphate. So atherosclerosis is basically calcium deposition in the tubules of your arteries. So obviously phosphorus, as it doesn't have any precursor and it can activate or it can be deactivated by any of the other supplementation. So when you are taking antacids, make sure that your antacids contain calcium carbonate rather than aluminium hydroxide, because calcium carbonate actively increases the absorption of phosphorus, whereas aluminium hydroxide binds to phosphorus in the intestine, reducing the phosphorus availability in the intestine. So similarly, laxatives on the other hand do contain sodium phosphate, and when you are increasing your laxatives, that means that you are also increasing your serum phosphate levels. So have a look on your laxatives also. So whether it is antacids or whether it is laxative, ultimately here also the importance of water comes in. So a good amount of water will reduce ghrelin in the system, that reduces the acidic secretion, and other one is laxative. So probably instead of going on to laxative through oral route, if you can try enema, that will reduce your absorption of sodium phosphate, and that can lead to normalizing the phosphorus in the system. So this is how the body functions. It's a very complicated structure when it comes to our notice, the importance of elements in the system, the importance of chemicals in the system and how they are reacting. So to achieving the best health, it is very essential that you take your nutrients properly. To achieve in the better health, you need to make sure that your food is in the right quantity. So that is the reason why the body is more healthy when you go on to a natural way of living rather than being more on supplementation. We'll be looking on to more such essential vitamins and minerals. So hope you like this video. Share this among your friends. Subscribe to more such intriguing elementals in the body. If you have any queries, you can always write it down to draadityahandi@gmail.com. So make sure to subscribe this channel, and hope to see you next week. See you around. Thank you.